Hello everyone, metering modes, that's what we're going to check out today. What is it? How does it work? And do you really need to know about the metering mode? Are some of the questions we will answer today for you. So let's click with me. My name is Capnogis and we are busy here at Click With Me to get you all the informative and creative stuff for your photography. Today's topic is metering modes. Love them, hate them, but you just can't evade them. Before we jump into the metering modes, let's get on to some basics of how our camera works. The working principle of all the cameras are based on three components: aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. This information is like now the most common and very widely known information, and probably all of you know it by now. So I will not bore you with the details of this exposure triangle. Let's move on to something more advanced, which is generally neglected in photography, which plays a very important part in getting your photos to as near to perfect as possible. Here I wish to talk a little bit about incident light and reflective light. Look at this example here to understand more. The light which falls on you from any light source is called an incident light. This light can be measured by a light meter, something like this equipment which you all must have seen in movies and commercials. Well, this is more accurate method of measuring light. The second form of light is the reflective light. You can see in this illustration, any light which reflects from any surface or subject is termed as reflective light. This is the light that is captured by our camera. All the readings taken by our camera are based on reflective light. So it is very important that we study this light more in depth. Now comes the question, why do you need different metering modes? The simple answer being, different objects reflect light in different manner and intensity, due to which it is very difficult for our cameras to know what subject is important for us and expose the photo with regards to that subject. Wow, I know, it's getting a little bit difficult to understand. Let's understand this with an example here. Look at these two examples. Everything is the same, just that metering mode has been changed. In the first picture, we have metered from here. And in the second photo, we have metered from here. This is how much difference it will make in your photos if you do not choose a proper metering mode. Now let's talk about different metering modes. However, before we move ahead, I would like to tell you that this is a three-part series. And if you want to check out the other two videos in this series, you can check the link in the description or on the cards over here. To begin with, generally, there are three metering modes which are basic in all the cameras. The nomenclature is different in all the different camera makers. However, basically, they are doing the same thing. The three metering modes which will be discussed in this series are zone metering mode, center weighted metering mode, and spot metering mode. The nomenclature for different brands is as follows. Canon calls it evaluative metering, Nikon calls it matrix, Sony multi-segment, Pentax calls it multi-segment, Olympus calls it digital ESP metering, Panasonic calls it multiple metering, and Fuji calls it multi. So this is all about nomenclature, but what actually is zone metering and where exactly do you use it? Zone metering is generally termed as the default metering mode for your camera. You can almost shoot all the scenarios using a zone metering mode. Only for more creative purposes, you would require some different metering mode. So my recommendation to you is to keep your camera as far as practicable in zone metering mode. And if you are using it in any other metering mode, have a habit to get back your camera to zone metering mode so that it will be ready for your next shoot. Zone metering works by dividing the screen in different zones and average them out to get the exposure reading. Each camera maker has a proprietary way of calculating their average, but generally speaking, the center zone or the zone where the point of focus is for that photo is given greater weightage in the average calculation. Generally, you can use the zone metering mode for all-round shooting, landscapes, cityscapes, wide-angle scenery, large group portraits. So this was all about zone metering. See you in the next episode of this series where we will discuss center-weighted average metering mode. Also, as promised, you will get your cheat sheet for metering modes right here down below in the description. Don't forget to check out the link and download your own print card. And as always, do not forget to click the like and subscribe button and do share this video with your friends and relatives if you like it. Till then, stay safe and click with me.